how fortunate we are today on Island Focus to have the opportunity to speak with Erin Enriques, recent graduate of Pearl City High School and a representative of the Hawaii Kids Can program. Thanks for joining us. Mahalo for taking the time.
Thank you.
Although you're a graduate now.
Yeah.
You have lots of time.
Yeah, it's really exciting and really weird.
What's on the plans now?
I'm headed to Washington, D.C., and I'll be attending American University, where I'll be majoring in international relations.
International relations. Fabulous. And I know that you were a participant in the Hawaii Kids Can program this last year. How did it inspire you or motivate you or influence you in any way?
So prior to Hawaii Kids Can, I knew that I wanted to go to international relations, but there wasn't really anything there to like push me in that direction or just to like support me in that. And Hawaii Kids Can has done just that for me. I've been exposed to so many things that I never would have thought I'd do or see. I've met so many interesting people. It's great.
So maybe explain a little bit more about the mission and your involvement with Hawaii Kids Can.
So Hawaii Kids Can really believes in the power of student voice, especially in our education system. Hawaii Kids Can really believes that students should make the choice about what we should learn and how do we learn, because education and students change over the years.
So it was advocacy, as well as information and action.
Yes.
And there was a special program that you were involved with, though.
Yes, so I was a part of the smaller extension part of it called WAVE, which stands for We Are Voices of Excellence. And we take everything that we learned in Hawaii Kids Can, we'll actually put it in action. So we'll be meeting with the leaders and meeting with teachers and administrators. And we get to have these conversations that as students, we don't really think we could have. And what breaks down the barriers between like, this is the adult and I'm the student, I can't talk to them about this.
And with WAVE at Hawaii Kids Can, you had immediate action and
yes.
results.
Yes.
What's an experience that comes to mind quickly where you got it, that it's possible for young people to have a voice?
So through WAVE, I got to help speak like a little bit at the Schools of the Future conference. And it was really interesting just to meet with like different principals and different teachers, because they were there to listen to me about what I think about school and how I learn and how do we make education better.
If you had a piece of advice for anyone who's listening and might want to get involved, what would that be?
Go for it. If you have an opinion, you should be able to feel free to speak it, even because education directly affects the students and students should be the one to speak out about it.
And how did you even get involved with Hawaii Kids Can?
It was really random. A past teacher of mine from Highlands Intermediate, she posted it about Hawaii Kids Can and their candidate forum, where the students got to be on TV asking governor candidates and the candidates for representative about their platform and what they believe and how they'll...
So she posted this event on Instagram?
Yes, and then I responded, and then it all worked out perfectly.
Amazing, right? Synchronicity, it's called.
Yeah.
So what's the dream now as we wrap up our conversation for today?
One day, I hope to start my own NGO, a non-governmental organization that focuses on helping girls' education in third world countries.
Well, we're going to look forward to hearing a little bit more about you in the future and all the wonderful international locations you visited and the work that you have in mind. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
Thank you for listening in to my conversation with Erin Enriques, who is a participant with the Hawaii Kids Can program. Mahalo.